started graduate though, really. Started 2015. Developing started just occasionally, and then as the years went on, we started becoming more and more frequent, to the point where I've had them every day for at least 2 years, a year and a half. And it took away my energy. I wasn't able to do my jiu-jitsu as I wanted to, feeling generally crappy. Anxiety, I never had a problem with anxiety, and even if I do encounter situations that would make me anxious, I never had a problem dealing with it, but all of a sudden I couldn't anymore. Skin breakouts, frequent toilet visits. Yeah, I wasn't feeling that great. And now, when I feel better, I realise how bad I was actually feeling, because that bad kind of became a normal state of being. For me, the main part was to accept the process. That's been the hardest part. Understanding that I was ill and understanding that I needed healing and all of that, no problem, but accepting that what I had to do to actually get there was the hardest. It took me at least a month and a half, 2 months, before I started to proper land in and realise, okay, this is what I need to do. I remember at the beginning, Dan said that I'm going to have to cut down on my jiu-jitsu. So I did jiu-jitsu 3 times a week, 2.5 hours at a time. And I remember thinking to myself, yeah, no, that's not going to happen. I'm not going to stop training. And I kept training. And the more I started going into the healing process, the less I was able to train. I actually didn't have any energy at all. And then I remember him saying that I might have to cut down on my gym hours because I went gym every morning. And I was like, no, that's not going to happen. I've cut down on my jiu-jitsu, so you're not going to take away my gym as well. But then as my healing progressed, I kind of felt what he meant. I felt that I have to take it easy, and taking it easy means actually doing nothing. And that's when started accepting the process as well. I stopped going gym, and you know when you've been working out or you've been doing something and 2 days after you feel the worst? It's kind of the same here now. When I stopped, when I really stopped, everything is came. And that's when I realised, okay, this is what he meant. Also something that I did struggle with in the beginning was to have faith in the protocol. Like it's so new to me, everything. I've got great faith in natural treatments and this way of medicine and all of that, but when it comes to, it's actually going to work on myself as well. So I did have to spend quite a bit of time getting in the mindset that this is going to help me, mm-hmm. and instead of being skeptical towards what I was doing. It's been a really, really good time. I learned so much, not just about healing and the body, but also about myself. And what that actually means. 4 months ago, if I had a day without pain, that was a good day. Now I don't even expect the pain to be there, because it's not. If the pain is there, it's because I've done something I shouldn't. So no, I can't. It's like 9 day really. It's like it's just switched over. God, my mental state is better than it's been in what, 10 years. I don't think I've ever felt this good as an adult. My skin is better, everything's just better. I've lost 9.4 kilos since the 1st of January. That's quite a bit of weight. So it's 9 days, really.